How are your tension vibes going around? While the exams are nearing, my dear MBBS Americos, feeling the heat, having mixed feelings? Don't worry, I am here with a new video about how to write and present your answers on the answer sheet to get more marks. Yes, I will detail you guys everything. This is for all years of MBBS who are going to attempt their final exams in the upcoming months. By the way, did you guys join our Telegram channel for MBBS students, where we posted handwritten notes for all subjects of final MBBS and also important questions that you need to study for all the years of MBBS? Link to our Telegram channel is in the description below. Go check out after watching this video and stay with me till the end, as you don't want to miss anything that I am going to tell you about how to present your answer sheet in next few minutes. With no delay, let's get it started. Hey guys, if you're new here, this is Dr. JT, general medicine resident and a part-time YouTuber, and I welcome you to my channel, Dr. JTM. We all study when there are exams. Everyone studies real hard to get good marks. But sometimes, though we study hours and hours to get good marks in exams, we won't be getting the marks we expected. Why is it so? Do you know why? Studying is okay, memorizing is okay, understanding is okay, but many of us fail at representing our answers on our answer sheet, which leads to odd impression for the person who corrects our paper. So this is my complete mantra and tips to get good marks by presenting your answers well on your answer sheet. Okay, first let me talk universally. This applies to everyone. Whenever a question paper was given, look at what all questions that you know very well and take a pencil and write down few important words or definition or anything that you remember at that immediate second. Just beside the question, you write them down. So when you start writing the answer, you will be able to recollect all that you studied. This funda helps you not to miss the important points that you need to mention in the answer sheet. Next, five basics of representing an answer sheet. 1. Good handwriting. Maintain the size of letters. Don't make them too small or too big. It should be mesmerizing to look at. Wait, where are you going not watching the video? I know your handwriting is not that good, but not at all a problem. There are a lot more how you can make your answer sheet as beautiful as you. 2. Neatness of answer sheet. You should not have more strike-offs, which gives shabby look to your paper and that makes a bad impression to your correctioner. 3. Maintain proper distance between each line and words. Your answer should not look like a messy study desk. Instead, it should look like a well-organized study table. 4. Underline the important lines. This is the one way you change the view of correctioners. When you highlight the points that you have written so well, which are direct textbook lines, they will think that your answers are of good quality and they won't go through the entire answer because you already impressed them by highlighting. 5. Colorful representation of your answer sheets. It's completely a myth that if you use multiple colors to underline or to design your answers will give you a good marks. No, using multiple colors will actually give a festival look to your paper. Instead, your paper should look professional enough. What I suggest is use only two colors, blue to write and black to underline or vice versa, and use pencil to draw diagrams or tables or boxes or flowcharts. If you follow these five basic tips while writing an answer, then you are right on to score some extra marks, because sometimes to some examiners, representation is greater than content. After you keep these five basics in mind, let's move on to which questions you need to attempt first. Is it 4 marks or 10 marks or 2 marks? And also let's talk about the time management. So when you receive the question paper, check if you know the essays well or not. Two methods how you can attempt the questions and manage time well. If you know both the essays well, do not start writing them both back to back, because the euphoria we have in the exam when we know all the question is real high. So if you start writing the both essays, then you will spend your entire time on them and you will hear last 10 minutes and still you are writing half of second essay. So write the first essay and then go for 4 marks. Complete all of them, then complete the second essay and keep the 2 marks at the end. Why you need to attempt the 2 marks at the end? Because even if you don't have enough time at the end of the exam, if you just attempt by writing one line of 2 marks answer, you will be awarded with 1 mark. But if a 4 marks or a 10 marks is left at the end, you can't write completely and you won't get the base marks at least. And in that pressure, you won't be able to recollect the big answers also. Time. An essay you need to complete within 25 to 30 minutes and a 4 marks within 8 to 10 minutes and a 2 marks 5 minutes maximum. Take a watch, keep a track of time, and you should always have 10 spare minutes at the end of your exam so that you can recheck the entire paper if you miss writing any answers or missed writing any question numbers, and also to decorate your answer paper. And importantly, after every essay or 4 marks answer you write, leave some space of 4 to 5 lines so that if you get any extra time at the end, you can add more points to the answer that you know well. In the next section, let's see how to present 10 marks answer, 4 marks answer, 2 marks answers. I will detail this section year-wise. First, with final MBBS, how to present 2 marks answer. Write very specifically and maximum half or one page only. How to write 4 marks answer. Describe in detail with neat diagrams or flowcharts, and every 4 marks should have one main side heading and at least 3 subheadings. How to present your 10 marks answer. So while presenting a 10 marks answer, first look into how the question was divided into. Is he asking etiology, pathophysiology and treatment? Our side headings should also be the same way. But always start with a definition or introduction as your first side heading. So this way you are showing the examiner that you know the basics well. And when you present a medicine essay, remember to represent pathophysiology and management part of the answer in a flowchart manner. This will be useful in 2 ways for you. Major aspect is that if you write in flowcharts, lot of time is saving. And second thing is you are making it easy for the examiner that what you are trying to express. In both medicine and pediatrics, treatment part is very important. So study them well, write that part well, and place the treatment in box. When it comes to the surgical part, to score high, you need to represent 2 things very prominently. One, draw diagrams wherever necessary. You don't need to be a professional here to draw surgical diagrams. The examiners will be expecting a simple line diagram. And second, make the content into tables. If you want to write differences or want to write criteria or classifications or TNM staging, represent in tabular form, which will change the entire attire of your paper. And in surgery, you don't need to write surgical procedures until unless asked. Just mention the names of that surgeries. And last, for gynops, the investigation part is major asset that you need to concentrate in gynops answer sheet. And also anything you write in gynops should be in point wise only. Not only this, any subject, don't write in big paragraphs. Write in point wise, that gives a neat representation. Next batch, final MBBS part 1. When it comes to ophthalmology and ENT, they are always highly volatile. So you can only recollect few points from what you studied. So do highlight them when you write. In ophthalmology, writing about drugs used and their side effects and surgical procedures names will award you more good marks. And also the ophthalmological signs that are given for each eye disease is also an important scoring area if you are highlighting them in a box. Whereas in ENT, writing various test names and their test procedures will give you good marks. When it comes to your favorite PSM paper, do remember your terminology in answer should be similar to that of Park textbook. So get habituated to that PSM terminology and present the answers the same way. Never write useless stuff in PSM, because this is the only exam where examiners go through into your papers in depth. So always put relevant side headings and write accordingly. And also writing statistical points will get you good marks in PSM. And next batch, our lovely second year MBBS students, how to get good marks in pathology. In this subject, whether asked or not, if you divide your answers into gross pathological features, hematological features and microscopic pathological features will give your answer a promising appearance. And it's even best if you draw the microscopic picture. Again, here the etiology should be in points and pathogenesis should be in flowcharts. Next subject, microbiology. Most volatile subject to many of you. How you can score well in this subject? You need to write mostly about the morphological features of the organism and culture methods and mechanism how it is causing the disease in flowcharts. When a question asked in parasitology, draw the life cycle in a circle chart first. That's more than enough. But if you have time, draw diagrams. If you have more time, explain what's in the circle chart. When it comes to pharmacology, adverse effects are the clickbaits for scoring high. Side effects means not just nausea, vomiting and diarrhea, but look into specific adverse effects related to drug and highlight them, then only you will get good marks. And classification of drug should be in tables, mechanism of drug should be in flowcharts, and uses of drug should be very precise and should be point wise. And finally, forensic. Highlight the points like mode of death, postmortem and antemortem findings, or in toxicology, the antidotes used. When you highlight or underline such points, there will be direct advantage of scoring well. So those are all the tips for your final theory exam preparation and also for how to write perfect answers to score well. Always remember, whatever you write should be confident. When you are not confident about the points you write, don't manipulate or create anything new. That will make the examiner deduct your marks. I hope you all should get some easy papers and wish you guys to score well. If you love these tips, don't forget to like this video and also share this video with your friends who really needed these things. And as a friend, let them also score some decent marks. And also do subscribe to my channel, Dr. JTM. I will come back with another great video. Till then, bye. See you again.